Thank you. I'm here just to present the results of this, which is another part of our project, but the main, let's say, person that is dealing with the, with this part is Professor Grzyb, which could not come, who could not come for the meeting anyway. So we are talking now about apples. As I told you, we have three kind of crops, and apple is the in Poland, I think, one of the most important. Poland is producing about 2 million tons per year of apples. The problem is that in organic farming, actually, in Europe, there is a possibility, I mean, there is a lack of production of planting material, organic certified. So even the EU regulation is allowing for a derogation, so the organic grower can buy conventional plants in order to plant an organic orchard. So we thought that it's important to see if it, there is a possibility actually to produce organically grown seed material, plant material. So we made this first trial in three different places, but we are presenting data only on one, from one place. In two years, that is 2010-2011, so the treatments were applied before the first year on the rootstock, and then also after grafting, the same treatments were applied to the Maiden trees. For two cultivars, we are dealing with the Topaz and Arriva. You have heard this morning from Franco that Topaz is one of the most important cultivars in Europe, which is also scab resistance. The same kind of treatments as I was showing before, but here we have two other treatments that have been also added. This is a plant extract which is reinforced with the amino acids, and also we have the same kind of products, which is a vermicompost extract, but it is also added of another product which is derived from molasses, so it gives a little bit more of nitrogen. Just very briefly, what are the main you see the main composition of the different products for the macro elements and micro elements too, and then you see that, for example, titanium has anything else but titanium. This we show already. So this is the field of the trial, and this is our most important person, which is the one that is actually making the measurements. So just we measure different growth parameters, so I will show you all these data. So we start with the trunk diameter, which is, and these are the data from the second year, so not on the rootstock, but on the plant that is already been grafted. And you see that with respect to the control, trunk diameter, you know, more or less all the different products are acting in the same way. We have also here again titanite, which is not really affecting, even though titanite is half, let's say, dose of manure receiving, so the this kind of treatment. For topaz, we have also the same situation. When we go to the tree high, also in this case, I think Mikosat was one that was in Arriva, providing the, let's say, the biggest trees. But when it comes to topaz, we don't have much differences. There are some products, for example, like BF Amin, which is also a product which is sprayed to the leaves, which is this plant extract. In this case, was more, let's say, active than the others products. When we have the frequency of branched trees, this is again very, very big, I would say, variation between the different trees. But so it means that there are no big differences for Arriva. But in case of topaz, topaz is a different, let's say, habit in, for what concerns the plant. And you can see that, for example, the humus sap, which is the vermicompost extract, as well as BF quality and BF amin, which are the seaweed extract and the plant extracts, were giving, let's say, better performance in that case. So it is for the seaweed is the same as the previous speaker, you know. So this we expect, and actually we have seen a kind of effect which is more pronounced on the hormones, I mean on the phytohormones levels. Just a picture about the different, and you see here the, you know, very, very, very nicely branched plants. Then we have also measured the number of lateral shoots, and here you can see that again Titanic is not working as well as the others, even less than the control in case of Arriva, but in case of Topaz it's working more or less. They are also the same. Again we have these two let's say foliar compounds, and again also Mycosat and Humusap, which are soil, let's say, fertilizers or amendments, because we cannot consider them fertilizers, which are also working properly, I would say. For the total length of lateral shoots, we have for Arriva and Topaz, I want to show you also there are some differences, but also again because of the different habit of the different cultivars. But again, we have always the same kind of products, I mean these two products and Mycosat that are providing, generally speaking, the better results. This is just to show you, know, the plants after the, let's say, taking the plants out of the soil, how they were looking. And this is what I think it is very important, at least for the nurserymen. This is the so-called side, let's say hidden side of the plant, which normally we don't care about very much. But you can see here the difference in the root system. You know, this number 2 is the MPK, number 8 is this BF quality, so this half manure and treated with this foliar seaweed extract. And you see the difference in the root system, and here also the same. I think this is something that we have not evaluated, but actually I was telling them you because I had some trials with another kind of plant, which is not a fruit plant, with maize, and we were treating half a hectare with these different products and also with Mycosat. And at the end, you know, we were looking with the grower. We went to the field, and he said, "Oh, look, the plants look the same." I say, "Okay," but then when he was just producing the silage, he had 30% more silage because, you know, the plants were much bigger. So I was telling them, maybe we can weight the plants and see, you know, the weight. But it's not possible to have a nice, let's say, measure because of, you know, you have soil and. There is a lot of error coming from that. So in conclusions, we can see that the different organic fertilizers and soil amendments that we have been used can be applied effectively, I would say, for the production of apple maiden trees. Actually, we have some effects of the different kind of products that we have used on the branching, for example, also in the case of this, let's say, microorganism consortium, which improved, for example, the branching, which is important when it comes to the production of first quality plants. We were very much pleased of the activity of these two products, which is the seaweed and the vegetal extract, which is enriched in amino acids, particularly for Topaz, which was showing the best results, and also for the vermicompost extract, actually, you know, the one that is providing nothing as concerned the amount of mineral elements, but it does increase the let's say microbial activity, so the general biological fertility of the soil. And then also for vinasa, which was the product that was used as was a waste, let's say, so we transformed the waste into a very good fertilizer, and we think it is a very good nitrogen fertilizer, actually, because it has a kind of 6-7% of nitrogen. No much results about Titanite, even though the producer was saying that it is a kind of exceptional product. And in generally speaking, so we showed that these are the four products that mainly were showing consistent results for the two different cultivars. And I think that what was important is that, as I told at the very beginning, we were doing actually these trials in three sites. One, it is in the experimental station, but two other sites are at nurseries. These are farmers, so we asked them to grow normally, but we didn't tell them what kind of products we are treating, with kind of products we are treating the plants. And at the end, they were asking us, because they were really very much pleased of the results, what are the products that we use, because they wanted actually to use the same products, also because we are not presenting here, but there were very nice results as concerned the let's say, protection, so the lower needs in, for phytosanitary treatments, for phytoiatric treatments of the plants that were treated with this organic products. And I think that's it. Thank you again.
Time for a question or two. Did you follow these plants out after after they were dug from the nursery and transplanted
yes.
into an orchard?
Yes. We are using these plants to establish new orchard, because we want to see actually the effect. So it will be this the first year, the effect, let's say, after in the orchard. Yes, we are doing that.
The effects of all the spine roots.
Exactly.
Convincing from that picture.
Exactly. And actually, we are also testing, because we have doing several kind of cycles of production. So we are also testing different methods of application. So not only to see if the application that we do, it is better to have in two times or three times or one time, to see also the economical feasibility of the treatments.
Thanks.
Welcome.
Okay. Thanks, everyone.
Thank you.